So something you may need to do from time to time is to completely clean off a Mac. This might happen if you're trying to resell it or maybe pass it along to somebody else. You want to get all your stuff off there and give them a Mac that's just like new. So the first thing you want to do when doing that is to make sure you're signed out of everything. So for instance, look in Messages, look in FaceTime, look in iTunes, look in the App Store. Look everywhere you can think of and sign out and delete accounts. You go into System Preferences. Make sure you've turned off all your iCloud services and you've removed your iCloud account. You can see I've done that here. There's nothing there. Under Internet Accounts, make sure you removed all your Internet accounts. You can be signed in for things like Twitter, Facebook, etc. Make sure they're all gone. Go into Mail and make sure they're all gone. You want to clean everything off. If you're using cloud services like from Microsoft or Adobe, make sure you've logged out of that, uninstalled those applications. Make sure everything's good and you won't have anything hanging around on this machine. For instance, you don't want to have the iMessage system still thinking this machine is something you should be sending messages to. You want to make sure you're signed out of everything. The only thing that you want to keep around is Wi-Fi. You don't want to sign out of Wi-Fi because to use the Internet Recovery function, which is how we're going to clean this Mac off, we are going to have to use the Wi-Fi so we can contact Apple and not only load in utilities that will help us clean off this Mac, but then reinstall the system clean and fresh. So what we want to do now is enter Internet Recovery Mode, which will, instead of loading the operating system from your drive, it will actually load the operating system or a simplified version of it from the Internet, from Apple. So it will allow us then to clean off the drive and reinstall the system. So to do that, we're going to restart. And when we restart, as soon as we hit this button, I'm going to hold down the keys Option, Command, and R. And that will put us into Internet Recovery Mode. And I'm holding down those keys here. And in a second, you'll see it show that we're doing Internet Recovery Mode. So that's what we're doing now. It's going to take a while for it to load the operating system remotely. So it's a good time to get a cup of coffee, have a meal, and come back when it's ready. So once it's done, and it took me about 20 minutes with a pretty fast internet connection for it to load this version to the operating system and present me with this screen. Once it's done, the next step you want to do is you want to choose from the utilities here, Disk Utility. So I'm going to choose Disk Utility and Continue. And this will allow me to erase the drive. So I can see here, here's my Macintosh hard drive. This other thing here, this OS X base system, that's what it just downloaded. Basically downloaded a temporary version of the operating system for me to be able to do this while I'm not using the hard drive. So I'm going to select that Macintosh hard drive and then here I can now erase the drive completely. I can do that by selecting the Macintosh hard drive under Macintosh hard drive, the volume itself. Go to Erase. I need to choose macOS Extended Journaled. And then hit Erase. And that will completely erase the hard drive while at the same time still remaining here inside this utility, since this utility is kind of, you can think of it as running in memory rather than running off the hard drive itself. And then once it's done erasing, I have a completely empty hard drive, but I'm still in this special mode where I can do other things. So once the erasing is done, I can quit Disk Utility and it's going to take me right back to the screen here. And now I can go and select Reinstall OS X. Now notice it says OS X, not Mac OS, as in Sierra Mac OS, but OS X. That's because when I bought this MacBook, it was El Capitan that was the most recent version of the operating system. So when I reinstall the OS, it's going to actually install El Capitan from Apple's servers, putting this machine back in its factory original state. And I can start that by hitting Continue. And then the process will take a long time to download the operating system, reinstall fresh copy on this blank disk. And the first screen that I'll see after that is a screen asking me to set up my Mac. And you don't want to do anything. You don't want to type anything. You don't want to enter anything. You don't want to click on anything. As soon as you see that screen saying it's time to set up your Mac, then immediately use Command-Q to quit the setup and then immediately shut down the Mac. What this does is basically when you start the Mac up again next time, it will start up in that setup mode, which is what you want to happen when you give the Mac to somebody, whether you've sold it or given it away. They'll get it just like they took it home from the Apple Store, asking them to set up their Mac. It won't have your Apple ID on it. It won't have any of your accounts on it. It'll be just like they bought it and it's brand new. And that's how you want to set up a Mac for selling it or giving it away. Tomorrow I'm going to show you how to do this if you're not actually giving it away or selling it. Maybe you just want to clean it off for yourself, or maybe you want to give it to somebody who's trusted, like a child in your family or a sibling or something like that. In that case, you may not want to reinstall the original operating system that came with it. You may want to install the most recent operating system, in this case Sierra, and it's a little easier to actually do that.